post-quantum cryptography for the real track, and we'll start with the first talk. So we have two talks. The first talk is entitled An Existential Unforgeable Signature Scheme Based on Multivariate Quadratic Equations by Kyung Han Chim, Cho Ming Park, and Nam Hoon Koo. And Nam Hoon Koo is giving the talk.
Thank you for introducing me. Thank you for introducing me. Today I will present about an existential unforgeable signature scheme based on multivariate quadratic system. This is the contents of my presentation. First, I briefly mention about post-quantum cryptography, especially Fourier cryptography based on multivariate quadratic system. And I summarize our contributions, and I explain about our new proposed MQ signature scheme named ELSA, and explain about security analysis of ELSA against known attacks of MQ signature scheme. And I explain about the implementation results of ELSA and compare with post-quantum signature schemes. Finally, I conclude my presentation. As you mentioned in invite talk this morning, if Shor's quantum algorithm is implemented, then public key cryptography based on integer factorization problem and the discrete logarithm problem are broken. There are several well-known classes of cryptographic primitives that are believed to remain secure in the presence of a quantum computer. Especially, MQPKC is based on the hardness of solving large problems, large systems of multivariate quadratic equations, called MQ problem in short. A public key is a system of multivariate quadratic polynomials, and a trapdoor is hidden in secret affine layers using the affine substitution affine structure. Its security relies on the hardness of the isomorphism of a polynomial problem. Most of the MQ schemes have been broken due to the uncertainty of the IP problem. A scheme based in MQ plus IP paradigm is not only based on the MQ problem, but also some variants of IP problem. There are only two exceptions from the MQ IP paradigm, HFEV minus variants and UOV variants. MQ signature schemes are superior to other competitors in terms of performance and signature size, but they have relatively large key sizes and no security reduction to the hardness of the MQ problem. This is a summary of our contributions. We proposed a new MQ-based signature scheme based on a hidden layer of quadratic equations. This method makes it possible to remove the use of the Gaussian elimination. Our scheme is the fastest public signature scheme for both signing and verification among the state-of-the-art signature schemes, including classic ones and post-quantum ones. Compared to other MQ signature schemes, our scheme has shorter key sizes, and we prove existential unforgeability of our scheme. In most of MQ signature scheme, a central map F is a system of n quadratic polynomials in n variables, which can be easily inverted. And S and T are two affine or linear maps to hide the structure of the central map F. And our public key is P equals to S circle F circle T to be hardly indistinguishable from a random system and therefore to be difficult to invert. And a secret key is a tuple S F T. How to construct the central map M is the most important part of the construction of MP signature scheme. So I explain about how to construct the central map in our scheme. There are four index steps, L, K, I, U, and this expression means the tuple of all variables in the this index set in the subscript. And M and N are determined like this, where M is the number of equations and N is the number of variables in public map and central map. Then the central map is determined like this. In the first layer, there are K polynomials that is the sum of L sub j times I sub ij for j from 1 to r and a quadratic polynomial pi sub I. Each polynomial in the second layer is the sum of L sub j times I sub ij prime for j from 1 to r and a quadratic polynomial psi I and a linear polynomial S sub I prime. S sub I is a linear polynomial in these variables satisfying this relation in the hidden layer where L is a linear polynomial in these variables and constant psi I. We call this relation in a hidden layer by the relation L throughout this presentation. Then lambda is this coefficient matrix of these linear polynomials, and lambda sub R is R by R invertible sub matrix of lambda. I sub ij in the first layer is a linear polynomial in these variables. This relation comes from these equations where the last equality is from the relation L in L in hidden layer. And the other equalities are trivial. So this term minus this term equals to this term. So we get this equality. Each entry of this matrix is a linear polynomial. So we can write this matrix as this coefficient matrix form. So theta is this coefficient matrix and theta sub k is this k by k invertible sub matrix of theta. And each pi sub I in the first layer is quadratic polynomial in these variables. And psi sub I in the second layer is a sparse quadratic polynomial in these variables of this form. Each R sub ij prime in the second layer is a linear polynomial in this variable. Similar to for the first layer, we get this relation and analog to theta and theta sub k. Delta is this coefficient matrix and delta sub u is this u by u invertible sub matrix of delta. And S of I prime is a linear polynomial in these variables. From this construction, we store only these ones instead of all the coefficients of F. I explained how to invert the central map F or to solve the f of x equals to r for given gamma. For f x equals gamma to given gamma. In the first layer, multiply L of x of L on both sides of equations to get this multivariate system by a relation L in the hidden layer. Choose a random unique vector S of L with L of x of L is non-zero. Plug it into this system to get a new linear system of k equations with k variables. New linear system can be solved by this matrix multiplication. In the hidden layer, plug s of l plus k into a quadratic system L to get this linear system of R equations with R variable. This linear system can be solved by this matrix multiplication. In the second layer, it is similar with the first layer. Multiply L of XL on both sides of equations in the second layer to get this system, this multivariate system. And plug this vector into this system to get a new linear system of U equations with U variables. This new linear system can be solved by this matrix multiplication. Finally, we get the solution of f of x equals gamma by performing only three matrix multiplications and computation of quadratic terms without Gaussian elimination. Next, we propose a new MQ signature scheme named ELSA. For key generation, choose randomly two affine maps S tilde and T tilde until they are invertible. Here, tilde means the inverse of each map throughout this presentation. And choose randomly these maps satisfying all the conditions described before. This map need to be invertible. Finally, compute the public key P. To generate a signature for message M, apply S tilde F inverse T tilde for hashing message HM in turn. To verify your signature, check this equation holds or not. I explain about the security analysis of our scheme against the known attacks of MQ schemes. These attacks are divided into two classes. Direct attack is to solve the multivariate system from public key P. Key recovery attack is an attempt to find equivalent keys of secret key. Key recovery attack using cookie is a generalization of rainbow band separation attack. And there are several well-known rank-based key recovery attacks. For direct attacks, we consider Grabner basis algorithm like F4 or F5 for solving the MQ problem. Complexity of the MQ problem is determined by that of the HGF5 algorithm, which gets some of the variables to create over-determined system before applying F5 algorithm. The complexity of HGF5 algorithm can be estimated by this formula, where degree of regularity is the index of the first non-positive coefficient in this expression, and omega is the linear algebra constant. In replacement attack, one can replace a linear polynomial by a monomial. So one can get a new central map of FR of this form. Because we set T sub R like this and let FR equal to F circle T sub R, then we get this relation. So, and the FR is still invertible with the same way with F. So, we can assume that the central map is FR when we consider the other rotations on our skin. Key recovery attacks on, using Wookie is such one example. We consider this attack for central map F and F bar. This is the symmetric version of coefficient matrix of central map F and F bar. Here, gray parts are arbitrary values and white parts are zero coefficients. This attack starts from this relation. We get these equations, and we get equations of this form. Since we have already known that some coefficients are zero by the construction of central map, so we get a new multivariate system. But this system has too many variables and equations, so we consider equivalent key and good key. If there are two invertible linear maps, sigma and omega, satisfying these equations, and f prime and f have the same structure, then this is an equivalent key of cyclic key. Here, the same structure means the same white part in coefficient matrix. So we can find equivalent key for this equivalent key for f, this for f bar. Here, diagonal blocks are identity submatrices. Let f hat be a generalized version of f bar with this coefficient matrix. Then we can find this equivalent key with high probability. But finding this equivalent key is still complicated, so we use the concept of good key to find it more efficiently. For this equivalent key, there are two invertible linear maps, sigma prime and omega prime, satisfying this equation, and F2 prime has the same structure with F in part, then we call this a good key. For central map F hat, we can find this good key, and we get same good key for central map F and F bar. So there are no effect of replacement attack on good key finding attack. The main complexity of this attack is determined by solving n-1 bihomogeneous equations and n quadratic equations with n variables. By our estimation, complexities of our scheme against all the known attack can be determined like this. For existential observability, please refer the paper for time because of time limit. Based on our Shapley-Lyon analysis, we choose this parameter at the 125-bit Shapley-Lyon level, and we summarize complexities of our parameter against all known attacks in this table. We implement our scheme with selected parameter on this hardware and this environment. It takes 6 microseconds for signing and about 13 microseconds for verification. Compared to other MQ signature scheme, our scheme has much better in terms of key sizes and performance for signing and verification. This is a comparison result. We can see that our scheme is the fastest in both signing and verification. Signing and verification among the post-quantum ones and classical ones. But our scheme has a relatively large public size. Our scheme has relatively large public size, so we are interested in reducing it. And optimal implementations and preventing side channel attacks are the part of our future research topics. This is the end of my talk. Thank you for attention.
Is there any question?
Do you have any open source? Is there any implementation of open source? Can
Thank you. There was a question.
I would just shout. Did I understand the central trick correctly? So you pre-compute the inverse, which is why you don't need Gaussian elimination during signing. Is that kind of a good one sentence summary, or did I miss another central trick?
Sorry.
So you said you reduce the signing time from n cubed to n squared. And it seems the trick that you're using is that you pre-compute the inverse so you don't have to do Gaussian elimination. Did I understand that correctly, or did I misunderstand that?
Maybe you will understand correct.
Was there a question? I have one. So is ELSA one of the 82 submissions that we have seen this morning?
Maybe yes. Maybe.
We've got one. Any other question? Yes.
I think the existential unforeseeability will be applicable to other signature schemes. Is not one. What is the difference of your schemes and other schemes? What?
I think that label scheme is also existential ability. It's not over.
Yes. Similar to our idea, rainbow scheme has also this unforeseeability. Also, our proof is not strict for existential unforeseeability.
No more question? So let's thank the speaker again.